It's always a glorious sight to see hockey in the raw. The sheer competition of it all, the spirit of the game and the crowds that adorn it. The Eastern Conference has a rather healthy mix of elite squads and teams in the doldrums of misery. How is everyone shaping up so far? So it turns out that the Bruins have smashed through that glass ceiling of mediocrity this year. They are once again a Stanley Cup contender, because if there's one thing that Boston needed, it's another good sports team. The main catalyst for this rise is an infusion of quality youth. Guys like Danton Heinen, Anders Bjork, Charlie McAvoy, Matt Grizzlick, Jake DeBrusque, and more. The Bruins are no longer a one-line team. They can potentially roll four. Do you want to know the scary thing? If management didn't totally fuck up the first round of the 2015 draft, this team could be even better. I would say this is more in spite of the boys' club than it's to their credit, but that's probably just me being stubborn. Turns out Dan Bylsma was far from the main issue that plagues this team. In fact, things have gotten even worse. You are trash. Oh dear God, this is a shit show. The on-ice performance is one of the worst teams in recent memory. There is an unimaginable amount of infighting in the locker room from all sides. Phil Housley looks completely overmatched as a head coach. Some of those awful contracts have finally bit Buffalo in the ass. Even after that deliberate tank job a few years ago, no progress has been made on the Sabres whatsoever. There is only one real solution in sight. Blow it up! Keep Eichel and Ristolainen. Spare no one that isn't a top prospect. This roster needs to be purged of all impurities. Good luck, Botterell. Buffalo, this year has been a walking disaster for your squad once again. The Bills helped to distract the fans from your calamity, but now it is front and center. If I can suggest to you one way to kickstart your re-rebuild, it would be the Wunderkind known as SeatGeek. It's an app that aggregates all available tickets on the resale market to help you find the best market value. Like all good scouts, it rates tickets on a 1 to 100 scale and color codes them for ease of use. It even goes a step further and gives you a view from where you'll be sitting. This little app also gives you a perk to entice. Use the code word TREE on the link below and get $20 off of your first purchase. I'd honestly consider hiring the app to assess player values on the market for the deadline. Wouldn't be much worse than your NHL talent assessment over the past few years. That, my friends, is the power of SeatGeek.
Hey, Rowley, we're gonna back to Bruins playoff contention again! The Hurricanes are storming the Metropolitan Division and taking no prisoners! So what if we're last in the division, we'd be fourth in the Atlantic? Barricade yourselves, Eastern Conference, a hurricane of human vigorous and intellectual mind! Carolina finally has secured new ownership for our ascension to dominance! That old piece of shit was sent to the guillotine! Our rise to glory is almost complete! Look at all of the fans coming back to me! Why aren't you coming to our game? I told the new owners you'd start showing up! Don't make me a liar!
The insatiable quest to finally win a playoff series is bolstered by a surging Artemi Panarin and a lot of slumping players. This team is what we could call very streaky. A team that wins 8 of 9, then lays eggs at random spurts. The offense and special teams have been lackluster this season, but Bobrovsky has been a rock in net once again. It always helps to have such talent in net, and it's complemented by a really strong defensive core, which should only get better once Ryan Murray gets back from injury. Speaking of injuries, you've had a lot of them this year. Seriously, this is getting ridiculous. So, enough hockey gods, stop! So it turns out the Red Wings didn't bottom out this year. You would think this is a good thing, but it's not. They're back into the unforgiving stranglehold of mediocrity, just good enough to not be in the basement. This team is literally being kept alive by Jimmy Howard and a handful of young players. Everything else is either cooked or uninspired. You ended up signing Athanasiou, but he, along with Mantha and Larkin, will be asking for paydays this offseason. What this team really needs is to bottom out so the remnants of the Empire can be cleaned and they can start fresh. Just like their new stadium, which is all but a ghost town most nights. No, Tree, that's not accurate. They're all out on the concourse. They're too distracted by its beauty to watch the Wings. Whatever helps you to sleep at night. The relentless gutting of anything related to computers or analytics this past offseason has gone about as well as expected for the Panthers. Another trip to the doldrums of irrelevance. Once again, nobody in Miami gives a shit as they rightfully shouldn't. Turns out shedding $10 million from the payroll leaves you with some of the worst depth I've ever seen. It's looking to be another wasted season for that young core, which has been totally fucked by an ownership group that has no idea what it's doing. By the way, just take a look at how well your old players and coach are doing in Vegas. Some great decision making, eh? What's next, blowing up your core because you're tired of their so-called failure? Sounds incredibly stupid, but with the idiocy on display the past few seasons, I wouldn't put it out of the question. Oh my goodness, who saw this train wreck coming? Besides everyone and their mother with a brain, Mark Bergevin's incredible adventures of fucking everything up even more in the offseason have borne the fruits of a putrid shit sandwich. Turns out that putting all of your chips into Carey Price doesn't work when Carey Price is having a down year. It also doesn't help that Carl Alsner is looking like a really bad acquisition and every other decision of note has blown up in their faces. Remember that great Jonathan Drouin as a center experiment? Predictable failure. Now he's back to his natural position. Still with no center to feed him the puck. Now you want to trade Max Pacioretty because, I expect a panic move or five to try and save Bergevin's ass soon. Go throw everything you have at John Tavares. I dare you. I was right that there would be a surprise team in the Metro this season. Unfortunately, I chose poorly. The correct answer was the Devils. Their rebuild got a nitrous oxide boost with an infusion of meaningful depth. Getting guys like Jesper Bratt and Will Butcher to perform at the level they have helps out with the team. This is where cold, unforgiving reality comes to play. The Devils are falling off as fast as they have risen. True, a lot of it has to do with certain players no longer playing way over their heads, but it still sucks. Even if you don't make the playoffs this year, Devils fans should feel good about their future. Guys like Nico Hischier can only be expected to improve, and Taylor Hall is a nice gunner to help him along. Just don't fall too far down the hole. The Islanders are once again doing Islander things and frustrating the living hell out of their fanbase. It has nothing to do with scoring, the offensive attack on the Isles is deadly. Their top line is one of the most potent in hockey, and the high-end skill on display is second to none in this league. However, there's a catch. Because it's the Islanders, there's always a catch. The defense is nothing but a turnstile. Also, your goaltending situation is utter excrement. Halak has not returned to form, and Greiss is no longer playing eons over his head. It may be another year of no playoffs while Garth Snow has near infinite job security. But you know what? Regardless of performance, it's time for celebration. The Islanders have finally secured a new home. They're staying on the island. Barclays Center is a joke that isn't built for hockey and is too far from their fan base. Also, even if Tavares leaves this offseason, Matt Barzal is looking pretty damn good. The future should be secure regardless. I can remember all of the bitching that Rangers fans did when I left them out of the playoffs. You're crazy, you all thought. The Rangers are too good to miss out on the postseason. It's looking like a realistic scenario anymore. This team is relying solely on Henrik Lundqvist to carry them to glory, and the problem isn't due to his inevitable decline. Henrik is actually performing valiantly. The issue is everything else. They failed to replace Derek Stepan, and it shows. The defense has been incredibly spotty, and it shows. They have suffered backbreaking injuries to key players, and it shows. In terms of analytics, they are one of the worst teams in the league. I know they aren't the be-all and end-all, but it's still very concerning, especially with how deep the Metro is. And now you might be blowing it up. Even then, James Dolan will still not give a fuck about the Rags. What a tragedy. To go from being one goal away from the Stanley Cup final to this. Everything has fallen to shit this season. Erik Karlsson still looks like he hasn't fully recovered from his surgery and is playing the worst hockey of his career. The system that Guy Boucher plays has either been completely exposed or not even a system. Craig Anderson went from stopping everything in his path to looking really old and worn out. Everyone not named Mark Stone is underachieving dramatically. And that's not even getting into that panic trade for Matt Duchene. Oh boy, even if Duchene is what he is hyped to be, you paid way too goddamn much to get him and hyped him as the face of the franchise. He is not. A skilled player, yes, but not a cornerstone. Still not as embarrassing as Melnick threatening to relocate the team right before the Centennial game, though. What a useless fuck. I don't get the Flyers. They baffle me in every way. I ask you a simple question, Philly. What are you? Are you the team that loses 10 straight games? Are you the team that wins 7 of 8? Are you a team that dominates over those with Giroux, Voracek, and Couturier? Are you just a team that holds itself back by overplaying terrible veterans? Are you going to let Brian Elliott disappoint you like he did in Calgary? Will you finally let your young horses out and fulfill your potential? I can't read you guys. Do us all a favor and let the real Flyers show themselves for the rest of the season. This inconsistency is doing a number on all of us. The truth will set us all free. Let's not lie to ourselves, the Penguins are in serious trouble. I know a lot of you are going to be upset over this, but if they don't turn it around soon, there will not be a three-peat. I think the thing that causes me the most alarm isn't the fact that they are a speed-based team that doesn't have much speed. It's not because the defense is trash. It's not because of that whole Antti Niemi dumpster fire. It's not even because the depth is non-existent. It's because of how terrible they are 5-on-5. This was their bread and butter during the last 2 years. They are being carried by a ridiculously successful power play, and who knows when that falters. I mean, I'm stubbornly trying to not give up. They're getting better, and they could pull another cup contender out of their ass. I want to believe, damn it! There isn't all that much to say that is terrible here. This team is goddamn loaded from top to bottom. Steven Stamkos has stayed healthy and has helped to anchor one of the best squads in the league. Andrei Vasilevsky is emerging as an elite goaltender. The depth is gushing with quality. Also, they thank Montreal for Mikhail Sergachev every waking moment. I knew there was a reason I was bullish on the Lightning this season, and so far they have not proven me wrong. Please stay healthy this year. Pretty please? What should have been the year where the Maple Leafs emerged as one of the top teams of the NHL has hit a snag. Or should I say they've hit about 11 of them. Toronto is in a state of near freefall since the turn of the year. Losing key defenders like Zaitsev hurt, but that doesn't explain how the offense is all but dried up for a lot of the team. This is the true test for the Leafs. They always say that adversity is the greatest judge, and Toronto is staring right into its pupil. It's time to earn that ridiculously large contract, Mr. Babcock. Show the world that you truly are the greatest coach in the league. Or stubbornly keep them using the same damn dump and chase tactics. It's yet another year where the Capitals are at the top of the Metro Division food chain. Of course, the regular season has meant nothing to their fanbase for a long time due to playoff futility, but I am not optimistic about their chances come April. Why, you may ask? No depth. It's one of the unfortunate side effects of strangling themselves into cap hell last offseason, and it has weakened their team significantly. Don't let the record fool you once again. This is a team that is merely being carried by Alex Ovechkin's will. Past experiences show us that top-heavy teams rarely go far in the playoffs, and the Metro Division is even more loaded in terms of quality than it was last year. Their high-end talent can only take them so far. They need more, but it's going to have to come from within. That means you, Burakovsky. So with the Eastern Conference being all but anyone's race, especially in the Metro, I'm going to do something either really bold or really spineless. I'm not going to make any predictions on the playoff race. Many of you are breathing a sigh of relief at this revelation, but I feel that trying to gauge anything at this point would just be a wild guess. As you can see with teams like Philly, momentum can swing in this league on a dime. The only team truly out of it is Buffalo right now. The question is which teams are going to pretend they are still competitive and buy at the deadline. Montreal, further embarrassment is calling for you.
And there'll be a great ovation for the first shooter. Welcome back to Tampa, Brian Boyle. Yet another ovation for Brian this morning. How much he loved having Brian Boyle on his team. He's got two, he's got three and four shots, and now he goes up high. Good job for Brian Boyle.